Hi everyone, so today I'll be sharing with you my top 10 apps for students. I've been using these apps ever since I started my master's and I love them. These apps are not solely based on my personal opinion, but I've also taken into consideration the reviews and what other students are gravitating towards and seem to love them. So they are free to download, so if you like them, just download them. But if you don't like them, then just uninstall them. So we have the following apps. Then our first app is Evernote. This is a note-taking app. It organizes all my notes for my courses. I have here my notebook for methods of research. Those are my notes for game-based education, for to buy list, for school supplies, for meetings, and stuff like that. What's good about this is it syncs every notes across all of your devices as long as you installed Evernote on your phone or on your laptop. The second app is Todoist. This is a task manager app. It organizes all of your tasks that you need to do with your life, just like the following for me specifically. It also shows the completed tasks that I've done for the week, so those are my achievements. And why I love it is because it reminds me every day of the task that I haven't accomplished yet. There. Another app is Google Drive. This is the safest place for my files. I have uploaded here all of my audio files, video, installers, and of course, the most important stuff are the PowerPoint presentations of my professors. So they are there. See? And with that and email, you can benefit from the unlimited storage capacity of that Google Drive. Photomat is a camera scanner. What it does is it scans the equation, any math problem that has something to do with equation or formulas. Then it shows the answer, and it also shows the solution on how you will attain that answer. Wow, life hacks! Especially that I will be taking statistics for the next semester. Then, another way of using this is to type the equation. So, we're there typing the equation of a math problem, and the same thing happens. It shows the answer, and it also shows the step-by-step solution and how to attain that answer. This is a very useful app, especially if you're struggling with math. Alright, there we have it. The next app is the Cam Scanner. This is a camera scanner. If you want to capture an image from a book or a text from a book or any physical document, you need this app. It does enhance, it kind of enhances, or here, it's cropping the portion of the text that I just want, and then it enhances that text, making it look like a digital file format file, and I can make sure, I can assure you that that is meant, that is so clear. And sharing is easy here because you can convert it either into a PDF file or JPEG file, which makes sharing easy. Merriam-Webster is a dictionary app. Of course, this is very popular. My professors always call me to recite and to tell the class the meaning of those words. So I'm always using this. So you don't need an internet connection for you to know the definitions of the words. Well, I have the random words that I've searched for the week. But if you want to hear the pronunciation, well, you'll definitely be needing a connection. English Grammar is another app that enhances your English grammar skills. It offers lessons for, let's say, nouns, verbs, like that, adjectives. And you can choose from different levels of exercises there. We have elementary, intermediate, and advanced. I am currently answering the advanced level, but I like to answer the elementary level. It goes that way. You choose from the options there. It's just a 10-item exercise. And then when you are done, answering those, you can see your scores. Yay! And you can view your mistakes so that you'll know the correct answers. See? Cite This For Me is a very useful app for researchers because it creates automatic bibliographies. I have here my bibliographies for Java books. I love Dital. Dital's the author of how to code in Java. He's very good at explaining things. And you can choose from the varieties of references styles like APA, Harvard, or IEE. So all you need to do is to click the plus sign there, type the file name for your folder, and then choose whether you will be using a book. Here you will be capturing the image of the barcode of the book found at the back of the book. So then it creates the automatic bibliographies as well as the inline citations. Cool, isn't it? You can also make use of the website option there. Just type the absolute URL of the website where you took your data or source or any other copied materials. So it must be absolute, meaning it must be complete, starting from the www. And to whatever text is in there. Then there you have it. Automatic citation, automatic inline text citation, and bibliographies. The next app is Google Calendar. This is very different from any other calendars because it's made by Google. And if it is made by Google, everything is synced. Every Google apps are connected to each other. So it shows my upcoming events. There's my birthday. Any event that is upcoming, future, or even past events that you need to look on. So it's great. Forest is the best app for phone addiction. If you're like me, that you're addicted to your phone, that you can finish your work because you keep on playing the games on your phone, then you definitely need this. All you need to do is to set the timer to whatever time you need your phone not to distract you. Then just wait for that time. Then it idles the phone. Well, you won't be hearing any notification from your phone. And you get to grow the trees and build the forest based on its name. See? So there we have it. Our top 10 apps for students. Let me know if there are other apps that you would recommend for studying. Or any useful apps that you use every day. And with that, thank you very much. Don't forget to like and subscribe here. And see ya!